And now, ladies and gentlemen, the real Don Steele.
KHJ Los Angeles. The real Don Steele.
Bang!
93 KHJ.
Bang, bang, bang. Boom, boom. I'm in the spirit. Loaded with the spirit, as a matter of fact. Happy 4th of July. 303 at KHJ. The real Don Steele show. Groovy doors taken for the giveaway this hour. Stand by. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
The summer of 68 brings a string of KHJ concerts to the Hollywood Bowl. Our first tomorrow night features Steppenwolf, the Chambers Brothers, and stars The Doors. The show's totally sold out, but you can be there as the guest of the Boss Jocks. Just listen for the word, call in, and win. A free pair of tickets to see The Doors can be yours from Boss Radio.
KHJ, Boss Hitbound. KHJ.
Boss Radio presents The Doors in concert tomorrow night at the Hollywood Bowl. Now, the show is stone sold out, but I've got a free pair of tickets. I'd like to give them to you, baby. Stand by, and I'll give you the word.
More music, KHJ.
Oh, yeah. Number two, a 3 dynamite hits in a row. 459 at KHJ. And the real Don Steele show, Doors. Gonna dig them tomorrow night.
Hello. I love you, won't you tell me your name?
Trade winds find galleons lost in the sea. I know where treasure is waiting for me. Silver and gold in the mountains of Spain. I have to see you again and again. Take me, Spanish caravan. Yes, I know you can.
Yeah, you're looking real good.
You know, the shell was designed to project the sound out, just that shell. Although there's 18,000 seats, so that's a lot of projection for that shell.
I mean, the shape of the bowl is like a big speaker, right?
So yeah.
If you're up in the back, I think you can hear it pretty damn good.
You ever been up there?
Yeah, I saw Miles Davis there. I saw the Stones there.
You did?
Yeah.
Yeah? The Stones.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Charlie Watts.
When we played there, there still was the big reflection pool in front of the shell. And so they covered that and put a green fake lawn on there. So really, we were in front of the shell. And we knew water was beneath us, which was kind of unnerving with all that electronic equipment.
Had Jim really been out of it that night, I mean, he was on acid that night, but had he fallen off stage, he would have fallen into the water, which would have been interesting.
All my contemporaries played there, Hendrix and the Dead and the Beach Boys, and I was jealous, but I was in awe. I wanted to be up there, and I was.
I think to the Doors or any artist, playing the Hollywood Bowl is kind of a goal.
Well, the Hollywood Bowl was always this incredible, iconic venue, you know. And to think that I would play there was like, whoa, you know.
How do you get to the Hollywood Bowl? You get to the Hollywood Bowl by limo, of course. But for us to get there, then we had to get a number one record, and then we had to play a bunch of places. And then we played Madison Square Garden and up and down the coast and started to play all over the country. And finally, the Hollywood Bowl called in 1968. In 1968, they said, we'd like you to play the Hollywood Bowl. And we said, well, by God, let's check our schedule. yes, I think we can make the Hollywood Bowl.
For them to score a concert there at the Bowl. And it, for them being a Los Angeles band, it was as if they were giving a gift back to the city, and the city was welcoming them and honoring them by allowing them to appear at the Bowl or inviting them to appear at the Bowl. So yeah, it was a big deal. I didn't know how prestigious it was until I finally started to hear the conversation around the office. I just thought for them at the beginning that it was another concert, but when I heard them talk about it, they felt as if it was something prestigious and something special and important.
So it was very prestigious. It was a great place to play, a real honor to play the Hollywood Bowl. Because we were just, you know, beat hippies from Venice Beach, California. There we were.
Looking at this Hollywood Bowl doc now, it's like some glorious psychedelic dream I had a long time ago. And it's real clear, it's in HD and beautiful. And I don't know who was playing drums, but he's good.
Again, I go back to the emotion of the Hollywood Bowl. That was the fun part, playing the keys with John Densmore and Jim Morrison and Robbie Krieger, genius Krieger on guitar, guy who wrote Light My Fire. Morrison and those lyrics, God almighty, those great, great lyrics. This is the end, beautiful friend. What a time, man. Brings a tear to my eye just thinking about it, you know. It was fabulous. It was our youth. We were in the prime of our youth. Never to be ever again for this guy. This body will never do that again. But it's always up here, man, always up here. Right here, you know. My guys, my band. Boy, was it fun.